After much drama, resort politics and hectic parleys, the Congress MLAs who were holed up in a hotel in Mumbai will now return to Karnataka. The Karnataka Congress firmly ruled out any possibility of desertion in its ranks soon after one of the party members who was deemed missing since the weekend reached a guest house in Bengaluru. The party has also called a meeting of its legislature parties, of its entire legislature party, to show its strength.
लेकिन पेपर में, टीवी में, हर जगह ऐसे अफवाहें फैला, बीजेपी फैला रही है कि उनके पास 10 है, 15 है, 20 है, बम्बई में है, दिल्ली में है, कहीं कहीं जगह के नाम बताकर वो लोगों को जमा करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। किसी को कहते हैं कि अब 11 हो गए, आप आ गए तो 12 हो जाते हैं। तो बहुत से एमएलए उनको ये भी पूछे, एक दो जिनको उन्होंने कोशिश की, भाई पहले 11 बताओ, उसके बाद में 12वां कोई तो नाम आएगा। तो ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है, सिर्फ अफवाहें उठा रहे हैं और लोगों को भ्रमित कर रहे हैं। एमएलए का उनको एक भ्रम में रखा जा रहा है।
Congress party, the Janata Dal government in Karnataka is stable. It was obvious one MLA, we only dropped him because of his lot of issues and indiscipline. The second MLA, we were supposed to give him some opportunity, he's a congressman. But still there are a lot of doors are open and we are on our job.
Disha Shah joining us live. Disha, we just heard the Congress point of view. Of course, they are assuring that everything is all right and there were absolute baseless rumors. The fact is that the five MLAs who were in Mumbai, we believe, are going to fly back to Bengaluru. Any update on that as of now?
Well, Afrida, today you're, of course, in the city of Mumbai in Renaissance Hotel in Powai. There are about 7 Congress MLAs. In fact, 2 Congress MLAs from Karnataka just reached about yesterday afternoon when the meeting was on between the Congress leaders whether to decide to continue the support to the political party or to withdraw the support. So all of these were the discussions that were taking place inside the hotel. We were there inside for almost 6 to 7 hours when we saw a few of the Congress MLAs also walking down the corridor, indulging in some serious discussions. But at this point in time, what our sources really confirm is the fact that all the Congress MLAs who are in Mumbai, they will go back to their constituencies by today. So when, what time it will be, that is something which has not been confirmed yet. But of course, we know for the fact that yesterday the agenda was bargaining of positions, Afrida, because at this point in time, all the rebel MLAs here are demanding a certain position in the Legislative Assembly possible. And that's the reason. So with the revised norms in this state, Afrida, few of them can be accommodated as corporation chairman or few of them can be accommodated as political secretary. And of course, we know for the fact that one of the Congress MLA is also demanding a position of the cabinet minister in concern. And we heard also our colleague, Bangalore correspondent Shrija, talking about it yesterday, that how few of the MLAs and ministers are ready to give up their post as well for the rebel MLAs to get power in the assembly in concern. So here there are several political developments that have come to light in the span of the last 3 days. Of course, since Saturday here in the city of Mumbai, at least 3 MLAs were camping. And then we saw in the last 2 days how there were more Congress leaders and MLAs who came here and joined their party leaders. So what is the Congress stand? This is something that we'll come to know once they really leave from here and make the decision and announcement.
Right, because this has clearly given the shivers to the Congress party. And like you are saying, that there's going to be a churning, there's going to be reshuffling and realignment of the forces now when it comes to the alliance. But can we now believe that, you know, the storm is blown over? What about the stability of the alliance? Are there more concerns even now, or is the worst over? Can the Congress breathe a sigh of relief?
Well, Afrida, the recent talks that are going on is the fact that, of course, what we know from the sources and concerned and what a lot of reports are also claiming is the fact that now the BJP, who wanted to really turn the entire strategy down as far as breaking the Congress-JDS alliance is concerned, that has really not really bared fruit. And that's the reason. In fact, yesterday as well, all the Congress MLAs here in the city of Mumbai were in touch with the Chief Minister of Karnataka and concern, and also with the Delhi High Command, because that's where they are getting major round of instructions as to what are the political movements, what can be done next. But of course, the BJP thought that most of the Congress MLAs, they can lure them into their party, but we'll know only once the Congress MLAs really come out in open and talk about it, because what were the discussions between the Delhi High Command and the Chief Minister, and between them is something which is very tight-lipped. Nobody's really talking about it at this point in time. Only when they decide to leave, which is about today, and return back to their constituencies, we'll come to know exactly what their stand is.
Right.
But we know yesterday, Afrida, in fact, a lot of reports also said that many Congress MLAs, in fact, the independent MLAs, also demanded luxury gifts like Jaguar and a lot of cars which are expensive, in between the range of 3 to 5 crore rupees. So here, of course, there are a lot of political developments, but what the Congress MLAs who have been camping since last weekend, what their stand is, we'll come to know only by end of the day today.
Right. So clearly there is dissension, and it may be true that they are now being lured back into the fold of the Congress party. But the fact of the matter is the story is not over yet. The situation continues to be delicate. And of course, there will be more developments, at least in terms of reshuffling and giving new positions to those dissenting MLAs. Thanks for joining us, Disha, with your inputs this morning. Meanwhile, 104 MLAs from the BJP are still holed up in a 5-star resort in Gurugram. Several meetings have been held and backroom negotiations are still underway over there in Gurugram as well.